if you remember from a couple of years ago, I did a review of the Dell XPS 15. This laptop was an amazing laptop. It had all the specs. You know, I had one of the few laptops that had 32 gigabyte of RAM. It was beautifully made with an aluminium case. It had the USB-C connection, which not a lot of laptops did have. It was quite expensive and pricey, but it had a decent CPU, okay graphics card. Wasn't made for gaming, but most of the stuff that you do, you could have done here. It was perfect. I loved it a lot, and I've used it for a lot of things. However, the only downside about this laptop is that it was huge. It was heavy. It was difficult to carry to work in the train. And over time, you know, your shoulders start hurting. So at that time, I thought to myself, maybe I need a device that I could take with me that is much lighter and more made for office. So I went for the Surface Pro, and I done a review about that. If you remember, this was again a great laptop with a detachable keyboard, and it also had a pen that you could use for making notes and stuff during the office. And the good thing about it, of course, this as well, is that you could use it as a tablet, and I put a skin on it just to make it look nice. So it was really impressive, very nice and very handy. However, when I go on holidays or when I go out and about, it was still difficult to carry. It was heavy with the power supply that I came with. It was quite bulky. So I kind of, as of end of 2019, I got the Galaxy Tab S6. Now this, what can I say about this? It's such a cool tool. Again, detachable keyboard, and it works as a tablet, and it had the GUI or the user interface that makes it look like a Windows machine called the Samsung DeX. Again, a good thing about this, it comes with the pen right here, of course, and the pen is rechargeable, which was good. But what I like about this is that it's convenient, very nice to carry on holidays, and I took it on holiday in January. It was really good, it was very convenient, it was very easy to handle. And the good thing about this is that if you use Microsoft Word or Microsoft Excel or any of the Microsoft tools and you pay for the subscription, you could use Office on any device. You could use it here, you could use it on the Surface Pro, you could use it on the Dell XPS. So you could just use all the different devices that you have, and you could just upload, or you could use the applications on the different platforms, so Android, Windows, or Mac, or whatever. Compared to size-wise, look at that. Look at the difference between this. I know this is 10 inches, you won't get much view, but for very basic stuff, really, for you to view things, this is absolutely perfect. It's really convenient and very good to use. And here you have it, people, the Galaxy Tab S6. Now this comes, of course, the one I have here is the LTE version of the Galaxy Tab S6. And what I like about this one is I bought it with the keyboard. So it's all here. You know, detachable keyboard. Now this keyboard is absolutely horrendous in terms of price. It's £160. And what my main issue with this is, of course, this part of the keyboard, or the case, the cover here, is magnetic. All this part is magnetic. So you could, you know, kind of, it's got a groove as well where the pen is held. However, this part of the keyboard case is adhesive. And people are complaining online that this adhesive keeps, people who stick, remove it and stick it back on, they have issues with regards to the actual case, as the adhesion wears off after a couple of, you know, times they pull it out or whatever. So that's the only problem with this case, is even though it's so expensive, ridiculously expensive, the actual case itself is quite poor in terms of the functionality and the durability. Now, of course, with this, it has a stand, so very nicely sits just like that. And then the keyboard, also magnetic, sits in just like that, which is absolutely great. This particular keyboard is about 359 grams in weight, and the actual tablet itself is around 420 grams. So you're just talking under a kilo with the charger, you know, whenever you go out and about. Now, what I like about today's technology is that, for example, if you have documents like Office or I don't know, Word or Excel or whatever, you could open it on any platform. You could open it in Android, in Windows, in Mac, everywhere. So that's what it's good about having a unified technology. Now with this switching on coming, this is of course the LTE version. So there is a slot here for the actual memory card if you want to expand your memory. And also there is space here for your SIM card if you have a SIM card, and you could add mobile connectivity. I haven't put a SIM card there, but I do have a SD card there. And it's great when you go on holidays and you put your shows and your programs to watch. Now, of course, this one here is password protected, and when I set it up first, it kind of installed all the application that I have on my Samsung Note 10. So pretty cool. Now, when the tablet starts, of course, it starts like this, but because I have the keyboard in there, it goes straight away to Samsung DeX, which is like the operating system, like basically Windows kind of layout or GUI. So it's more easier for you to navigate and do your stuff. But if you want to exit DeX, now of course I'm going to be using the pen. Now this pen has roughly about 4096 sensitivity points. So people who want to sketch or draw or whatever, they could use this functionality and they could easily do what they want to do with regards to their productivity. Personally, I think Apple has a better pen and functionality, but it comes at a cost. So this kit cost me about £800, right? Because I got it on discount and sale or whatever. But if you are going to buy this from Apple with the same functionality, you're talking about at least $1,200 or whatever. So you're talking about a lot of difference in terms of price. So Samsung Note, and you just could just do whatever you want. And what good thing about this is, for example, if I clear this right now, and trust me, my handwriting is terrible. You could use a keyboard. You could use here. And if I write, for example, I'm holding this upside down, by the way. So I'm trying to write upside down. So I'm holding this upside down, but I'm going to write something in upside. I can't write hold, for example. Right. I'm terrible at writing this upside down. But you could do so many things. And what I like about this is, like, whenever you press the button here, because it's got a button there, and it just erases it. That's so cool. You know, and then you could write again. Hello, for example, and then you could do all sorts of things. And if you know what, if that's not good, press the button and it just deletes it. It's just so convenient. And like, look at that. If you see how it gets thicker, so the way I hold the pen with an angle, the whole thing gets thicker. Look at that. So that's I love this. This is so convenient for people who draw. And whenever I go to my meetings when I'm at work, and I go to a meeting and I take this with me, first of all, I impress everyone that I got this cool gadget. And at the same time, I got a small device that does everything for me. It's convenient to carry, it's light, and it's pretty amazing. Now, this one has a 8 GB of RAM and also has a 2.8 GHz octa-core CPU. I think Qualcomm it is, CPU. And also, it's got 4 speakers right here, 2 here, right there, and 2 here on this side. When it comes to connecting your laptop, all you do is this. Bang! And look, straight away, I've configured it to go to Samsung DeX, which is the kind of Windows look, or the, you know, the standard Linux look of GUI for people to use. And again, my icons are there. It's touchscreen. I could do exactly the same thing, which is very handy. And I love the way it's kind of being developed and easy to handle and use. Now, you have to get used to the actual Android application. But you know what? I think over time, you should be able to without any issues. So with regards to battery life, this has a 9-hour battery life for internet use. It has a 15-hour battery life for video playback. But I think if you connect the keyboard, you might have, you know, a little bit less. That's what Samsung claims that it will last. So I don't know how much truth that is into it, but close enough. It's pretty impressive for it to last that long anyway. Also, with regards to the cameras, there is one 8-megapixel camera right in the front, right here. One 8-megapixel, I'm not sure it's visible, it's right there. And also, on the back, there are two cameras, one 13-megapixel, and one 5-megapixel camera, and they are able to record at 4K 30 frames per second. And the screen as well is the AMOLED, Samsung AMOLED screen, which is very nice and is one of the best screens out there anyway. Again, what I love about this is its functionality and capability for me to take it to my office. And compared to the Surface Pro and compared to the actual Dell XPX, it's another different system with regards to its power and functionality, because the CPU capabilities is a lot less than the actual other laptops that I have. However, for office use or for holidays, this is more than enough. And just the fact that you could read your books, you could do all sorts of other things from here is just impressive and very, very, very handy. With regards to recommendation, and if I recommend this, I absolutely recommend this, I don't know, to the fullest. This is just an amazing piece of kit for you to use when you're on holidays, when you go out and about. So it's absolutely stunning. The only thing is, of course, it comes at the cost. The cost is much cheaper than Apple's costs with regards to this sort of thing. And if you have Android phones, then man, you know what? This is no brainer, really. You just buy that and have everything synced with your applications, and all the purchases is kind of synced as well. Now, of course, this the keyboard comes in one color. The actual Tab S6 comes in two colors. It comes in this mountain gray, which you'll never see because of the case, or it comes on a rose blush. I kind of like the mountain gray because, you know, more, I don't know, I like it compared to the other one. And here it is, guys. I really hope you have some idea about this device and it is able to help you to decide to buy something in the future. So I hope you've enjoyed watching this video. Please click on my other videos regarding my other technologies that I've reviewed. Again, the Surface Pro, or Microsoft have released the Surface Go, which is similar to this, but I think this is a lot more convenient for me. It's very small, very light, and it works. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel for future videos regarding technology. I hope you've gained some knowledge about the Galaxy Tab S6. Or the Surface Pro or the Dell XPS. Remember, I do a lot of reviews. Let me know in the comment section below about the different devices you've used and which one has been more convenient for you if you have more than one device. I'll hope to see you in the next video, guys. Take it easy.